So, since the announcement of Slayer Mancher 2, there has been a lot of mystery behind it. Specifically, the slimes that inhabit Rainbow Island. But what about diet, behavior, and interactions with the player? In the trailer, we see a small glimpse of what some of the slime's main diets may be like. Other than the trailer to go on, we don't know any additional information of what these slimes or other additional slimes that may be included in the sequel. In this video, I'm going to break down of all the confirmed slimes, an analysis, if you will, of what we know so far of the new slimes included in the sequel. Let's get ranging. So far confirmed in Slime Rancher 2 are 5 new slimes: the Codden, Angler, Flutter, Batty, and lastly, the Ringtail Slime. The Tanuki, aka the Ringtail Slime, starting out from the starter slimes, is the Codden Slime. First seen in a trailer as the newer slimes in Rainbow Island. It is more than likely that the Codden Slime will be the most common found slime in this island, similar to the Pink Slime. Its behavior is going to be just like any normal rabbit, just hopping along, minding its own business. As for diet, we have seen from the trailer eating some sort of cabbage. Now, in the trailer, it was depicting a larger variant of the Codden and the Flutter slime. It is unknown at this point whether or not that its favorite food is the water cabbage. But more than likely, considering that rabbits in real life love the taste of vegetables. Even in the Wikipedia, it states that its main diet is vegetables. Up next is the Angler Slime. Currently, it's unknown on this slime's behavior, diet, as well as interactions with the player. We have seen a glimpse of what this angler will be like in-game just from the trailer. One of the screenshots depicts of the angler eating the newest hen, the dodo hen. However, this is also a larger variant of the pink and angler. So it is unknown whether or not that's a behavior from the pink slime eating the hen or the angler. More than likely, it is the angler because the real life angler fish does eat other fishes. Other than that small bit of information, we don't know much about the angler slime yet. Up next, we got ourselves the Flutter slime. Just like the angler slime, the Flutter is a very mysterious slime. We don't know its diet, behavior, as well as interaction with the player. But just by screenshots alone, it's more than likely going to be another common slime found in certain areas of the Rainbow Island. In one screenshot, we see several larger variants of the honey and the flutter slime. So it's not hard to say that the honey and flutter slimes has some form of connection because we often see them together in larger form or not. We have also seen this slime in your new ranch. Will this slime spawn in your new home? Or will it spawn somewhere else within Rainbow Island? Continuing on is the Batty slime. Another mysterious slime that we hardly know anything about it. However, we do get a good glimpse of what the Batty slime will be just by the trailer. In the trailer, we often see the Batty slime in dark areas like caves. Will the Batty slime be just like the phosphor, only coming out at night? Will it disappear when exposed to sunlight? We just have to wait and see. Lastly is the Ringtail slime. This slime was not depicted in the trailer, but there was a small glimpse in some of the screenshots. Many people thought it was some sort of Tanuki slime. However, thanks to Nick Boafish, he confirmed it as the Ringtail slime, a creature that is actually based on real life of the same name. Unlike the other slimes that was previously mentioned, there's extra information about the Tanuki thanks to one article. In one part of the article, it states that the Tanuki is some sort of quote-unquote garbage disposal and it holds a deep secret. Now, when you think of a garbage disposal, you might think of the pink slime that eats practically anything. That's the same thing with the Tanuki slime. Now, as for its secrets? This secret is neither good or bad. It's a feature that we have to wait when the game is announced. Will this new secret will help the player to unlock a new feature, or something else that both of them want to wait until the game's release? Another behavior that the ringtail might have is its mischievous nature. Despite this screenshot alone, its face depicts on something bad or mischievous that it's about to do, or at the point of doing. The ringtail is a distant cousin of the raccoon, and we all know raccoons can cause trouble and mayhem to your home. It's not too far off if the ringtail causes some sort of damage or steals something from your home. Come a mixture of a tappy and a pink slime, where the tappy's main quirk is stealing objects. Now, before I end this video, I want to also mention a possible slime we may see in Slime Rancher 2, which is the Meteor Slime. The Meteor Slime was originally meant to be part of the Glass Desert expansion update. Unfortunately, it was scrapped due to engine limitations back in the day. However, thanks to its unusual magnetism, the idea of the Meteor Slime also inspired the creation of the Dervish Slime. Now, with new people on board, as well as additional experience for the team, it is possible that the Meteor Slime may come back with a big return. Who really knows? Okay, I know this isn't a new slime quotations, but what about new larval variations like the puddle and the fire slimes? I think Nick Bovich created a Twitter post announcing that all slimes will be in the new sequel. I am unsure. I tried to find the original tweets. You could correct me in the comments if you like. But if it's true, it's possible we may see other larval variations that was not included in the first game, like the fire and water slime that I previously mentioned, and the quicksilver slime. What about the twinkle larval? Why stop there? What about Gordle variations? Other than mods, it would be nice to include other Gordles like the slimes I previously mentioned, including the Twinkle Slime. I just hope they still keep the party Gordle, or at least another variation of it, because come on, it's nice to boogie every once in a while, right? And that's essentially it for all the starter slimes in Slime Rancher 2, and theories of possible slimes that may be included. What do you guys think? Is there any information that I missed of any of the slimes I mentioned in this video? Let me know down below. If it's your birthday today, happy birthday. Like always, stay wiggly!